Every Tuesday morning, the Chiefs meet with Dr. Corey to discuss their careers. They affectionately refer to this time as Tuesdays with Corey.
You are the worst Chief residents in the world, especially you, Armando. Where'd you get that beard? You buy it? And you, Reimer, quit coughing like a little girl. You're supposed to be a leader. I am so disappointed in you. And now we got the caterpillar man. The mustache, he needs to shave off. Should have done that before he left the academy.
Lindsay, of course, was spared due to her obstetrician's orders that she not be berated in the third trimester. Corey thinks that's crap. Imbued with a new sense of purpose after their weekly beratement, the Chiefs find a new way to teach the house staff. Under the guise of a requirement of eye compare, the Chiefs decide to have residents perform standardized patient encounters. With a little bit of a twist.
Come in.
Hi. Hi. I'm Zach Wegerman.
Hi.
One of the residents here. What can I call you?
I guess Dr. Zoss.
What's going on?
You know, life just sucks.
What's that?
I mean, I guess it's probably work sucks.
Anything in particular at work that's been sucking?
Everything.
Mm-hmm. How's that making you feel?
Bad.
Mm-hmm.
Just...
Is there any chance that might change at some point?
If the ACGME shuts us down, I guess I could quit.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. And has there been any warning that you might be shut down, or is this just a concern of yours?
There's been a couple warnings. Maybe we chose to just ignore them. Which, you know, probably not the best idea. You know, maybe it was the email that, you know, telling them to go screw that I almost sent, or thought I almost sent, but then I really sent. So, I check my email like 500 times a day, waiting for the shutdown email.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. So things have been quite stressful at work.
Yeah. Surprise!
Yeah, like, this is way too like weird. I was just waiting.
Yeah.
Hey there. My name's Mark Sansky. I'd love to wash my hands. It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. So you're a doctor?
Yes, sir. I'm a third year student. I'm a third year internal medicine resident.
So you're a resident?
Yes, sir.
Do you still get to call yourself a doctor as a resident?
It's nice to meet you.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Ralph Corey.
Pleasure. I heard today was just an annual appointment.
I was reading that annual appointments are worthless, but we're still doing them, I guess.
Well, the things we like to do, if you haven't within the last few years, we like to screen people for high blood pressure, high cholesterol. If you're interested in being screened for prostate cancer, that would be something that we would address.
How would you screen me for prostate cancer?
Possibly a rectal examination.
I don't want that.
That's fine.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Have you done this before?
I haven't biopsied prostates, but I've had these discussions and done rectal.
No,
surgery.
I was thinking of the annual physical. Have you done these before, doctor?
I have.
After an additional 15 minutes of Mark trying to be as comprehensive as possible with his review of systems of Dr. Corey.
Have traveled a little.
Where to?
Everywhere.
Do you eat local food, drink water? Who doesn't?
That or starve.
Sure, that's fair. I'd love to examine you if that'd be okay. I usually have people get up on the table. Usually I have them put a gown on. if you want to at least take your sweater off, I can get my stethoscope under your shirt.
Before Samsky had another chance to offer prostate cancer screening.
Do you mind opening it all?
Surprise!
I don't understand.
You agree, man.
What is... I don't understand. It's what?
You just got punked.
So this isn't really an eye compare thing?
No. No.
Dr. Van Kirk.
Hi.
Good to meet you.
Nice.
Just wash my hands quick.
Is there a male doc? I thought a male doctor was supposed to be
seeing
me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Did
someone give you that expectation?
Yeah, that's all right.
Well, we'll go ahead and get started. What brings you into the clinic today?
I just have some pain just down my belly. It's more when I pee, actually. Like, it just kind of burns. But, I mean, I don't like spicy foods. And I don't think I've had any hot sauce, but that's what it feels like.
It feels like?
Like hot sauce.
Oh, like hot sauce. Okay. Yeah. All right. Are you currently sexually active? Have you or your partner ever had an STD that you know of?
Not that I know of, no. Is that something you can get from like a toilet seat or something?
So, no. I know that's a kind of a common misconception.
What about a urinal? Like, sometimes I stand really close.
No, that probably won't put you at risk. Obviously, we try to encourage good hygiene. Well, let me, I've already washed my hands, so let me go ahead and take a quick listen to you.
Sure. Can you hear the burning?
Can
you hear the burning? Like, why are you listening up there?
Oh, I'm just trying to examine you head to toe here so that we
gotcha.
Make sure we're not missing anything.
Sure.
Remainder of exam censored. She didn't miss anything. Anything.
You know, a couple things that this could be, one urinary tract infection, kind of the symptoms you're describing, the burning and the...
Surprise!
You've been positive. Good job.
Wow.
We almost stopped you a little earlier.
Hi.
Hey, doctor.
My name's Dr. Buggy. It's nice to meet you. I'm one of the senior medical residents here at Duke.
I'm Lindsay.
Hi, right, Lindsay. Over here, give me 1 second, okay?
Okay.
Lindsay, would you like to sit down? Be a little more comfortable?
Aren't you good? You don't want the... I thought I had to do this every time I went into the doctor's office.
No, not necessarily. It depends what we need to do today. But why don't you have a seat? You can come on down even if you'd like. So, Lindsay, what can I do for you today?
So... This isn't working for me.
Okay.
First of all, is it too late?
When was the last time you had your period?
April.
Okay. So it sounds like you're pregnant, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you taken a pregnancy test?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I'm pregnant.
All right. And so you're here today to understand further options for not becoming pregnant again?
Yep.
Is there anything going on in life right now that's...
Oh, no. Life is good.
Okay.
Life is great. I just want it to, like, stay great. Like,
okay.
I don't need to bring this into the mix. It just ruins your life, right? Like, no sleep. They poop. They cry. I'm just not interested.
Okay.
So how do we not do this again?
Not do that again. Okay. Well, that's something we can talk about. That's not a problem. About that. Have you ever been on birth control in the past?
Yeah, well, one of my doctors prescribed it. They prescribed pills.
Okay.
I don't like suppositories.
Okay. And by suppository, you mean something that's going to be inserted rectally?
Yeah, the pill.
Okay. So typically, the pills that we prescribe for birth control, you actually take orally, so you take by mouth.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. This is just a second.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Yeah, it keeps happening. It just hurts.
How often does it happen?
Yes!
Is this real?
Hello.
Hey.
How are you doing this morning?
I just don't feel good.
Sorry to hear that. My name is Dr. Yankee. I'll be seeing you today.
Nice to meet you.
What would you like to go by?
Jennifer.
So tell me a little bit more about what's going on.
I'm just feeling really short of breath. I'm like, really dizzy.
Okay. How long would you say this has been going on for?
I've had episodes like this before. I'm just not thinking very well today. So, when I was 18, I was like jogging and I passed out and was about to get married the prior time, and I was stressed, and so I just thought it was that, and I just like was walking one day and passed out.
Okay. So that's something as well.
Oh, I feel really nauseated.
Is it like gonna get you like a bin or something? Jen?
Oh my god. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh my god. Ah. See, we get a defibrillator.
Wait. Isn't she DNR?
Is she?
I don't know, call Carol.
Alright. She probably does.
Is she DNR?
Hey, no.
Are you okay?
Yeah, Jen's dying. Let her go.
She's DNR?
Yeah. You cannot hold it together.
Surprise!
What is going on?
You two are terrible.
Was this a prank on me? Oh my god, I'm like, what just happened? That's good. What idea was this? This is good.
Having completed their resident training, the chiefs meet with Dr. Corey to debrief.
All right, that was okay. Now can we please teach these interns how to call a consult? Just bring back the music.
So bring back the music? What the f*** does that mean?
Hey, earmuffs.
Yeah, man, you can say anything after earmuffs. You can say...
Maybe he means sing a song about consults?
Yeah, that's probably what Corey means.
Yeah, sounds about right.
From the bed.
It's so typical of you to say it's not a stroke. I'm sorry. I hope he improves. But did you notice he can't walk or talk and his pupils fully blown? It's no secret that his neurons are running.